Welcome to another semester of The View, where we center our news around you. In this week's episode of The View, we have announcements, video segments, sports, and a look at what's happening in our Bear Nation today. The View starts now. What's up, Bears? It's Friday, January 21st. I'm Rand, and I'll be hosting The View today. Just a friendly reminder to wear your masks properly in the building and your classrooms. Make sure to cover both your mouth and nose. I know these masks can be challenging to breathe in, but please try to stay in compliance with the mask mandate to make sure everyone, including you, remains safe. Another friendly reminder to students that we do not accept any outside food from delivery services such as Uber Eats, DoorDash, or pizza delivery. Please bring food from home or use the dining services in the cafeteria.
Yes.
Now let's go to Yomari for our weekly announcements.
What's up, Bear Nation? Welcome to a new year and a fresh new semester. My name is Yomari Jackson, and I'll be bringing you the announcements today. Attention Photography Club members. Your January general meeting is today after school in Ms. Booker's room until 3:30, where you'll learn to make your own photography website. Attention Tri-M members. There will be a general meeting today after school in the band room. And attention Cultural Wave Club members, your general meeting is January 24th after school in Mr. Moskowitz's room. Are you ready to get your dance off? There will be a dance marathon after school today from 4 to 8 p.m. in the Commons area. So come on down and show us your dance moves. Seniors, if you have not already checked out the seniorsmvhs.weebly.com website, the official date and time for your graduation ceremony is Saturday, May 28th at 8:30 a.m. in the Gas South Arena. Also, freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, I know you may have already heard, but here is your reminder to visit your homepage on eClass to register for your next school year electives. Make sure to find some time to get that done. If you don't know already, January 25th is a digital learning day, so stay home and stay comfy. Let's bring the announcements to a close with a few birthday shout-outs. Happy birthday, Eowyn Holly, Sherry King, and Veronica Cross. But also a happy belated birthday to Ehite Gizaw and Emily Jennings. Now for this week's joke. What do clouds wear? Thunderwear. Well, Bears, that wraps up the announcements for this week. Back to you, Rand.
Thank you, Yomari. Now let's go to Marielle for the weather updates.
Happy Friday, Bears. I'm Marielle, and welcome to our first weekend weather segment of 2022. How about that snow last weekend? I hope you got a chance to get out and enjoy the beautiful snow. Here's some photos that were sent in by our viewers. I love that. Oh, that's really cool. Now, on to our weekend weather. Today's weather is going to be pretty chilly with a high of 40 degrees and a low of 29 tonight. And tomorrow will peak at 42 degrees and will lower at 25 tonight. And on Sunday, you can expect sunny skies with a high of 45 and a low of 23. That's all for this week's segment. Have a lovely weekend. Now back to Rand.
Thanks, Marielle, for the weather update. Now let's go to Matthew for the sports update.
Thank you, Rand. Welcome back to this week's sports. I'm Matthew, and I will be bringing you the schedule, scores, and updates for our winter and spring sports. In wrestling news, the wrestling team finished in second place at the Region Duel Tournament and qualified for the state duels for the eighth year in a row. The Bears defeated Peachtree Ridge 57-20. The Bears defeated Collins Hill 54-24. The Bears defeated North Gwinnett 45-21. And the Bears lost to Mill Creek 34-28. Are you interested in cheer? There will be an interest meeting on February 28th. For more information, visit at MVHS_cheerleading_ on Instagram. In basketball, we won our game against Lanier with a score of 68-45, putting our overall score at 14-6. Our next game is against Collins Hill at Collins Hill on the 25th at 3 p.m. Our swim team's last meet was at the County Championship Preliminaries meet at West Gwinnett Aquatic Center yesterday, but we don't have the scores yet. Well, Bears, that concludes our sports updates for this week. Thanks for tuning in. Now, let's go back to Rand. Go Bears!
Thanks for the sports update, Matthew. Teachers and students, please be sure to support your student athletes throughout the year. We have some great athletic programs at Mountain View. Let's take a look at a SkillsUSA feature story that Jackson, Eric, Marielle, and I created for Broadcast News Production Competition.
Welcome to another edition of SkillsUSA News. I'm Jackson.
And I'm Rand.
Today, we start with heartbreaking news. Betty White, beloved star of the Golden Girls and pioneer for early television, has died at the age of 99 due to natural causes. To continue her legacy and love for animals, fans of Betty began a new trend on social media, the hashtag Betty White Challenge, aimed to raise a large amount of money to donate to local animal shelters. The trend exploded, and on the day of her death alone, the Young Williams Animal Shelter received $500, helping to pay for life-saving veterinarian services for many of the shelter's animals.
And if you searched her name to participate in the donations, Google might have asked you to accept cookies. But what are they really? Cookies are made to track a user's web history and possibly use that information to personalize ads. For Google and Facebook, the process of declining cookies has undergone an investigation by France. They found that while it takes one click to consent to cookies, it is significantly harder to refuse them. This sparked France to fine the two companies for a total of more than 200 million euros, which is roughly $226 million. Both Facebook and Google have made public statements making it clear that they are working with authorities to resolve this issue to protect their users' privacy, with Google beginning by eliminating third-party cookies. Overall, European countries are beginning to take more control of their technology. Last year in Germany, new laws were put in place to allow it to intervene earlier and more effectively to ban companies from using anti-competitive practices. This past week, we saw Germany's antitrust watchdog put Google under closer antitrust scrutiny. The regulator's decision, which lasts 5 years, gives it extended powers to supervise Google for abuse control. I'm Rand.
And I'm Jackson.
This has been SkillsUSA News. Thank you for tuning in. Please wish us luck in the competition. Teachers and students, do you have news you want to have featured on The View TV? You can now submit announcements to be featured on The View. Scan this QR code to access the form. Well, Bears, this concludes this episode of The View. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow our Instagram and Twitter page at Mountain View High School TV for any updates throughout the week. See you next week. Take care of yourself until then. And as you go about your day, always remember, life is like a stage and someone is always watching. Stay excellent, Mountain View.